Ready. Set. Courtesy. I'm a dedicated martial artist. Student crew begin.
Oh yeah.
I must develop myself in a positive manner and avoid anything that could reduce my mental growth or physical health. Number two.
Oh yeah.
I must develop self-discipline in order to bring out the best myself and others. Number three.
Oh yeah.
I must use common sense before self-defense. Never be abusive or offensive. Number four.
Oh yeah.
Winners never quit. Quitters never win. I choose to be a winner. Number five.
Oh yeah.
This is. We are. We are. We are. What's up? Ready. Set. Courtesy. Alright, so, first, I haven't tried this out yet, but during a little scrolling through TikTok, I found this video. So it's, let's wait for it to start from the beginning. It's four burpees. And then seven regular push-ups, and then six diamond push-ups after that, but yeah, you guys saw that. But anyways, to me, it doesn't look that hard, so I thought, hey, I'll try it out for the first time on this video. So, let's do it here. Actually, maybe if I face this way, you guys can see it. All right, go. One, two, three, four. All right, now six push-ups. One, two, three, four, five, six. And now bring them in. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, TikTok debunked, I guess. I don't know. It was good, but my review on it, wasn't enough to tire me out. So, yeah. Alright. Now, what I want you guys to do is get into this bear crawl position again. Like this. And walk side to side. Alright, so you guys are going to be doing that, and then, you know, same old, when I say go, you shoot out, do a push-up, and, yeah, and then you keep going, alright? So, start going. Go. Go. There we go. All right, go. Go. All right, now stand up. All right, guard stance. All right, go.
I think it's time to blow this thing. Get everybody in the stuff together. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Let's jam. Let's stand. All right, punch it. All right, all right. All Alright, now, jump on kids. Alright, so shoot. Alright, knees. They can be round knees or they can be straight. Other side. Alright. Now, next one. What you guys are gonna do is so it's kind of like a sideways crunch. You're gonna be in a crunch, but you're gonna turn sideways. In, up. It's kind of weird, but it's working your obliques, I think. Yeah, so we're doing that. Alright. So, that's not the funnest on a hardwood floor. So, yeah. Alright, but, yeah, I think that's decent warm-up. Alright, so, my back kind of hurts after doing those crunches on the hardwood floor, but I still want to do them. So, I got a pillow. So, if you got a hardwood floor, you need a pillow, that's fine. But, I still want to be able to do these. So, let me figure this out. Alright, cool. There we go. That's easier. Or not easier, but look. Softer. There we go. Still burns, but it's cool. All right, and switch. All right, cool. Yeah, those are difficult, especially like me. I haven't been working on my obliques. Probably should. So I'm gonna try and add that into next cycle's videos. Probably tomorrow's Zoom also. All right. So, this is gonna be just like it's sort of a warm up, but it's a focus drill. You guys are gonna need like a pillow or something that you can punch. Right, and a partner. All right, so, one partner is gonna have the pillow, and they're gonna be moving it around. All right, just every which way, and you have to focus on one spot. So I'm going to focus like at the stem of this eighth note here. I'm gonna focus at like this little piece of the stem. All right, and when the pillow reaches there, I'm gonna punch. All right. This can also work with high five. So if you don't have something you can punch, if you don't have a partner that that wants to get punched in that direction, then high fives, move your hand around, and then, you know, give them a high five. This should take like 30 seconds. Yeah. Alright guys, so, how many of you guys have taken class, in like, Pro Tech, where we were doing bow as our weapon? So, you've probably done a drill, where they throw tennis balls, and you have to do, like, hi, and hit the tennis balls, or, you know, strike the tennis ball out of the air. You see it coming at one particular spot, keep your eye on the ball, and then, you know, home run. So, that's kind of what I want to imagine when I'm doing my Psy form, or any form for that matter, alright? So, imagine the tennis ball, imagine, like, a dot that you're trying to hit. When I go that way, I'm focused right on this little piece of air. I want to push that air molecule out of there. Alright? And then punch. Alright? I'm looking at that same spot. Alright? So, practice the Psy form just like that. Alright? Set. Oh yeah. Circle. Alright? One. Two. Three. One. Two. Three. Alright, this exercise will also help you look before you strike. So I close, I look at my spot, index in, index out, and I double punch. Alright, now I look at where I want to strike, boom, collarbone, and then I look, I high block, I look, and I see that place where I want to stab, boom, alright, boom, boom, open, open, boom, 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 and then all the way in, and then, yeah, and set, yeah, courtesy. Alright, so that's what I want you guys to work on, is focus on that little dot that you're striking, alright? Because that's, one, going to help, you know, with focus, what we're working on, but also accuracy and intensity, because the intensity gives you intent, it gives you a target to strike, and accuracy, you're practicing striking a small target. So, yeah, focus kind of works with pretty much every single principle of a black belt. Alright, so now that we've done the Psy form slow, we've focused on our targets. Now, we're going to put the Psys down for a minute. We're going to spin 10 times. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I'm dizzy. I'm gonna find my Psys, and I'm gonna try and focus on that same part again. Boom. Boom. It's a little bit harder. Actually, a lot of bit harder. And then, you know, it gets easier as you get less dizzy. But those first initial strikes are terrifying. And then open, open. Boom. Boom. Boom, boom, yeah, and set, yeah, crazy. Alright, so I want you guys to do that spinning thing two more times, and then, then await further instruction. Also, I brought up the drill with the tennis balls, and striking the size, or striking the tennis ball with the side. So, if you have like a stuffed animal or a tennis ball or something that, one, won't break anything, and two, won't break itself, you guys can have someone throw it at you and you hit it back to them. That's a good thing to do, but, not everyone has those materials, so don't worry about it. Alright guys, so next week is strike test, I think. Yes. Next week is strike test. So, for your videos and for your Zooms, you're going to need your top and, you know, your pants, belt, star sheet. You guys are red belts. You guys know this. But, it's next week. Alright, let's get into Action Cry Form 9. Action Cry Form 9. Yeah. All right. One, two,
Focus on that dot from the side form. 3. 4. 5. Yeah. Yeah. 1. Keep that head nice and level. 2. That's still 1. 2. 3. Nice and level. 4. Oh yeah. Then step, roundhouse, chomp, punch, step, boom, and then roundhouse, horse stance, look, 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 feet together, chomp, side kick, and show. Alright, so, yeah, that's actually I Form 9. You guys know all the moves already. If you don't, that was there for you to practice that. I have an extra I Form review Zoom that goes on at 6 o'clock on Wednesdays. Yeah, I don't know. I got the request to do it, and, the adults are taking it, which is great. And thank you to Jackson Young. He also took it, and he was a great example to help teach the forms and stuff. But yeah, so I have a review. If you need help, I slow down the forms and I teach it as if it were like week one of a cycle. So yeah. Alright, now that our minds are kind of clear, we got distracted a bit, let's get back into Axe Cry Form 9. Axe Cry Form 9. Oh yeah. Go. Oh yeah. Step. Kick. Oh yeah, look, 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 chop, side kick, and curtsy. Alright, so, with Action Cry Form 9, I just want you guys to practice, make sure you're looking at that little dot, that point where you want to hit, alright? I bet that if you drew a dot on your screen with, like, I don't know if there's a marker that's safe for screens, but if there is, notice that my hand hits, like, you know, right there on that screen, and then I punch, and it replaces its position. It's, like, the same spot. So, if you can do that, if you can record yourself and see if that matches up, great way to focus. All right, guys, so, in drumming, there's this thing called a paradiddle, and it's one of, like, the more beginner, rudiments, or, like, you know, drumming, like, patterns, I guess. You take your right, so when I say right and left, I'm talking about which stick you hit with, so right, left, yeah, right, left, right, left, left. So, I was doing this, like, I was just tapping it on my chest, and I realized it's a great focus drill. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. Ah. There we go. But, yeah, it's, I don't know, it's very difficult, so if you guys want to try that, it's just a little extra thing that I don't know, it's cool. Alright, out of my trouble. So, you're in your chair, right? You see them coming, step, block, parry, grab, throw them, alright? You know, pretty basic. So I've been having you guys start off in horse stance, but if you can get a chair, it's a lot harder to maneuver around a chair than it is to maneuver from a horse stance. So if you have something you can use, go ahead. My bed sort of works, so I'll try and use that, but you sit, you see him coming, move, block, parry, And then my bed is in the way, so I have to kind of maneuver my leg around to get it out of the way. Alright? So, just practice in the chair. I don't want any trouble. Out of the way. Blah, parry. Boom. And then smash their face. I don't want any trouble. Boom, boom. Boom. Alright? Practice that a few times, and if you can get someone to either punch you, that's optimal. But that's great. But if you can't get someone to punch you, have someone clap for you so that they'll clap, and that's when they start the punch, and then they'll clap again, and that's supposed to, you imagine them ending the punch. So it should be, all right? So the first clap is when you react, and the second clap is when the punch is fully extended, all right? I did this in a Zoom class, so if you remember that, try and do that on your own or with, you know, your parents or sibling. All right, guys, so we just did the chair self-defense, so now let's move on to the iron broom. Alright, so guard stance, alright, step out of the way, block, parry, now turn, crescent, and then turn again, take a knee, and then sweep, and then come back up. Alright, so what I want you guys to do is, again, if you have a partner, you can have someone throw a stuffed animal or something and you have to crescent kick it out of the air. If you don't have a partner, then another focus drill you can do is, look at that dot, but place your hand there, alright? So, you look at that dot, alright? You spin, you keep your hand on that dot, alright? And then you kick it, alright? Then you go, whoop, alright? And then, or if you have, like, a pool noodle, you could stand that up, or, like, my lightsaber, it's over there, but, I could stand that up, and iron broom, sweep that out of the way, Alright, recap. So, stripe test next week. Belt, uniform, star sheet, that's all you need. Wednesday, 6 o'clock, there's AK form review. It kind of moves at a moderate pace because the only people I've had so far are Jackson Young, way to go, being a role model, and I've had adult fists. So, they're learning the forms for the first time, but they're also adults, so they're learning it pretty quickly. It moves at a pretty good speed. So if there's, anything that you need work on, just show up. I've been focusing on, like, certain forms, but the class doesn't have to be just, this week has to be AK7. Or like something like that, right? It's a tool for you guys. So if you come, just ask me questions, be like, hey, can we go over AK4? We can go over AK4. It's cool. It's more of a relaxed class. I think that's about it. So, yeah.